I am Kuruchi. I am in the headquarters of the Medical Association of Taranto in the presence of the President Nume and Montorsi. The speech will be given the general practice specialist, Morfeji.
Good morning to everyone. Today I want to explain our project about quaternary prevention and hypermedicalization and about fragility disease and overwhelming. Approximately 15-20% of patient doctor meetings are defined by the latter as difficult. Difficult patients are defined as those who elicit strong negative emotion for their physicians. If not acknowledged and managed correctly, these feelings can lead to diagnostic errors, unpleasant confrontation, and troublesome complaints and legal claims. So there are no difficult patients, but difficult relationships due to characteristics of the patient, the doctor, and or influences of society. In this second and third slide, we can see different tables which administrative to the doctor attending general medicine course. The aims of the study is evaluating the relationship of the difficult patient with the over-medicalization and how much it can affect the clinical practice and public spending. About material and methods, work group of the vocational training of general practice of Apulia region has involved an evaluation from on difficult patient and over medicalization, which was administrated to doctors who attended the general practice office. In this table, we can see the questionnaire which was submitted to 121 doctors attending the specific training course in general medicine. In this table, and in particular in the first column, we can see different types of patients: hypochondriac, non-polarizing, psychological, non-medical source, excessive medical appeal, exigent, suspicious, light, and other. In the second column, we found the number about each patient. In particular, in the first line, we have with 97.5% hypochondriac patient, followed by non-collaborating, excessive medical appeal and non-medical source with 95.9%. In the third column, we have excessive and inadequate use of health services. And we found, which 51.2% excessive medical appeal. About excess of medicine causes delays throughout, we found non-collaborating with 28.9%, followed by psychological with 24.8%, and followed by suspicious for 24%. Finally, here we have use of validated medical practice where the benefits are not clear, potentially harmful and cause of waste. And we found non-medical sources for 51.2%, followed by non-collaborating with 32.2%. In this table, we can see four different definitions of quaternary prevention, but the most doctor answered correctly with 76.9%, like action taken to identify patients at risk of over-medicalization to protect them from an aggressive medical approach and suggest interventions that are ethically acceptable. In this table, in the first part, we found pathologies in which we can find the over-medicalization. In particular, we found chronic degenerative disease with 35.5%, followed by disease and cancer. In the second part, we found pathologies for which there is an evidence of overdiagnosis. We have dementia with 42.2%, followed by hypertensive heart disease with 33.9%, and followed by mild depression with 32.2%. Here we can see the causes of over or sovra medicalization, and in particular with 60.3% we found lack of integration between energy and specialist, followed by defensive medicine with 58.7%, followed by competence towards depression request of function with 55.4%, followed by mass media pressure with 36.4%, and finally, followed by economic reason with 33.1%, like industrial pressure, professional interest, and social power. In this graph, we have underlined through our study that whatever prevention can be linked to disease, to illness, to pathologies, but we have a greater consumption caused by pathologies that are poorly qualified or by economic reason, defensive medicine, or mass media pressure and other. In this table, we understand that whatever prevention has many limitations, and so it takes a lot of studies to improve our ordinary work. We present a table to improve the health system. About some advantages, for example, we can implement in the last years of university the practical internship of the general practice, coordinate the execution of examination and therapies in comorbidities, adoption of standard design protocols, and telemedicine, for example, clearly after internship and practical medicine. About conclusion, it emerged that from the observation of the colleagues, the collaboration between various subfields, general practice and specialists is opportune to better identify the difficult patient. So I have finished. I hope that it was interesting. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Warrior, and thank you, Dr. Jason, for the amazing presentation. If anybody has any questions, please send them. Very good. So, we will not be taking a break. We would like to go ahead with the presentation as considering the time that we're in. So, I would like to invite Dr. Zui Zhu.